want to take questions?
Sure, I can take questions.
I was going to ask your like DIY space for your students. I mean, do you think that would be useful if the campus sort of centralized something like that? I know a lot of campuses, and even a lot of libraries have maker spaces, basically, you know, with all kinds of stuff for making things. I mean, would that be?
Oh my gosh, that would be.
Because that sounds like a lot of work for an individual to put together.
And then people are bringing things, and then how do you get rid of what you don't use?
Yeah,
And could other colleagues benefit from some of it? I mean, it's really great. That would be a great idea. And isn't that what that called, a community, learning community?
But
like in the library where you're having people access, I'd love to have my class in your library, and then the librarians could be there, and actually I could expand some of this into research. And then they could have access, so it could be a multifaceted, I hadn't thought about that, it could be a multifaceted way to have them learn, like, what is the efficacy of, you know, hand strengthening activities for the child with muscular dystrophy? Do you go there? Sleeping patterns in people with addiction. A lot of them complain of lack of sleep. What in the research says that? Well, does my activity go with the research? Is it evidence-based? That would be neat and be worth talking about. So really, the sky's the limit. You only limit yourself in this process. I really think flipping has a lot of implications. Are there other questions? Yes.
So, you know, personally, what is, you know, as you've reflected upon this, what did you gain out of this?
I gained that I can be a really creative professor that the students want to, they want to be in my class. They don't like, you know, that one of the things I got was probably a half hour in one of my classes. So how did it go this semester? Because we've changed a lot of things, and boy, did I open up myself. It's so hard, I can't do it, and those kinds of things. But then they're totally negated by their product. Yeah, it's hard. Learning's hard. Someone said, what was it? I'd rather be dead than think. I mean, it's hard. It's hard to think. And one of them came up to me after, I am so sorry, I don't want you to take offense to this. I didn't say I couldn't do it, I just said it was really, really difficult for me. That's what you're paying for. You're paying to stretch yourself. Well then, let's do this. So it was a lot. I got a lot of feedback, but I've learned that, I don't like being taped. It's really helped me get through some of my things. I still watch myself very much, you can tell. But you can watch my clips, I'll give you my access if you want, and let you see my courses, I don't care. But then you can see and do it better than I did. I learned that one of the things that they didn't tell me at the onset is for accessibility, that they really need to have a transcript or something with them. So that's something I have to work on this summer, is what I did say and how can I have that.
We have tools for that to help you.
Oh good, because I wasn't gonna sit there, and that'd be a long day, many days of doing it. And I ended up flipping actually 3 weeks of my 15-week class. And that's a bit. So if you wanted to start small, I'd take like one or two classes and see how you do it, or how you do, and then you can always expand. But I did 3 weeks and then added a big assignment. Just as an aside too, is I made a toolkit for pediatrics, and I thought I'd be brilliant and do it with my psychosocial course. I teach psychosocial concepts with another practitioner in the area, and the students complained, because you saw the complaints, the cons with the students about what they said about flipping, but they were upset that I did not flip my psychosocial course to allow them the same format as I did with my pediatrics course. So just so you know, it works. I'm imperfect at it still. I'm still trying to toddle around figuring out how best it's going to work. But they were really upset that I didn't flip my psychosocial class. We need to do that next time. And okay. So I have my work cut out for me for that class as well. So, yes?
I'm I'm wondering, and they're excited, even though they're really doing more work, it seems like, which is great, but I'm wondering how much you assign them for a particular assignment. I mean, like, do you assign 2 or 3 video clips for them to watch as they're reading as well?
Yep.
I'm just trying to get a sense.
Yep,
for the
I do reading, I do the video clips, and they have to do the probes. So I haven't lined up on any of my reading and things like that.
So
because they're doing it out there where my class time, they're getting time to work on one of their assignments. So, I mean, it might be slightly heavier, but students who walk in your class for the first time may not know that anyway.
True.
So it, with that new credit scheduling minutes, like one of my classes got cut by 20 minutes next year. That's huge. How am I going to do my job in that class? I'm gonna flip. I don't have much choice because I have standards in OTA and we can't cut anything. If anything, we're adding. So yeah, I didn't cut the load.
So for like a typical week,
they've
got their normal reading assignments, and then like how many video clips would you assign and learning probes?
So one of the things with video that you'll find out is when you're lecturing in a class, you have questions that come up during the class, which extend your present. You know, if you had a presentation made, it's extensive. By presenting, you cut to the chase.
Yeah.
You know, you don't do a lot of long storytelling
or ad libbing.
You know, yeah, you're not. Mm-hmm. You know, it's like, okay, let's go over this again, which just soaks up time in the classroom. So what could be a 45, 50 minute class, you know, you can pare down actually to maybe 20, 25 minutes of straight presentation on a video and breaking those up into, you know, say four or five videos. And that would make the difference.
And your probes could be in your reading. So you could make it so that it works. So load-wise, if you do it right, like sometimes I did, I asked questions that were in the reading because I wanted to make sure they read certain things that I really wanted them to make sure that they had their head around because I was going to test them on it. I felt it was important when they went out. You know, I picked my poison. So yeah, it does. Like one of them was like the families, there's four. I think they're no more than 7 minutes. So that was that whole lecture right there. And they had little probes, but they were, this one I put in the reading. Like I made it about my reading, so it really does help them because then it makes them crack that book open that still crinkles when they open it, you know, like it's brand new. Because that's what I did. I'm like, I'm gonna ask that question. I flipped through the chapter and just picked out things that I thought that they really needed to know. And then if it's on your test too, then they see the importance. Or if you have a quiz when they first walk in before you jump into your activity, and it's on those probes, they're golden.
So,
it reinforces it.
One good activity, especially with reading, is have them mind map it. You know, take a section or a chapter and say, you know, I want you to create a mind map around this. And let's, you know, so they can sort out what the thought process is, you know, in that activity. Then they got it, you know, they got to
look in class? Are you talking about an in-class activity?
It could be an in-class activity. You know, I mean, there's all kinds of activities that you can draw from, but you know, where you take, okay, I gave you a presentation, mind map that. You know, so they have to get what the core concepts are, and what major points are being drawn, and what the supporting aspects of those, and that forces them to really pay attention to what the presentation is or what they're reading.
Or you might want to flip it, and you just said, well, could I do that in class? If they're really having trouble with your textbook and you feel that they're not reading, if you show them kind of how to approach it, some students, they're not used to reading, like we read. Maybe you'd want to do that in your class and have a mind mapping activity and have them work in groups doing that so then they find the benefit and how to do it and how to manage your course, and then you reinforce it with your test questions and your assignments. Oh, that was important. Wow, now I know how to approach the textbook. I know how he thinks and how he wants us to get this information. So that's not, I would think that would be an excellent class with mind mapping, particularly in psychology. You put a psych twist on it. It could be fun.
Definitely.
I thought of English too. I didn't know who was gonna come. English, you know what you could do is have the Elmo on the computer for part of the time and teach them how to grammatically correct sentences being grammatically correct. And then also, you could also help them write a passage and show them how you do go through that thought process and actually typing it and showing them and what other word can be used. Here's where you find the source on the computer. I mean, you could do a ton of that, like editing your writing and how could we edit this to make it better. And then when they come in, maybe you have an exercise, they're supposed to do a little simple paragraph or a couple paragraphs, then you have them come in and edit each other's work. That's their job. And you're supposed to catch the errors, you know? So then they learn, they add other people's and maybe they add their own, or I don't know how you do it, but I mean, there's a lot of different things for writing because I know my students need to write better. So, I don't know if that helps. I thought about that though. Computers, I had a little more trouble, Dave. I was having trouble with mine this morning. And I will tell you, about, you know, take the terminal out, the parking lot, drop it down, run for it. No, just kidding. this is how you fix a computer once and for all. No, I'm just kidding. But I could see different, if you're doing programming language and things like that and actually showing them what that looks like and then have them try their own, like your homework, and flip it and see if they could do it in class to make sure that they have the rudimentary things so they can go to more advanced things. That, I mean, that was something I came up with there. You know, statistics and formulas and that gave me a bad flashback, but it could be fun. I think it's a great